Spare Room with Karen Terry.
Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about how to set up a school roleplay. School roleplays, of course, take place at a school, and they're really popular to set up because they're single location. So it's either going to be everything happens at school or on that particular campus. And everyone that's going to join your roleplay was likely a student at one point in time, so it's familiar. The most popular school roleplays tend to be high schools, boarding schools, or universities. So what do we need to think about when we're setting up our school roleplay? The first thing we need to consider is the age of the characters in this roleplay. Is this going to be a high school roleplay where the characters are going to largely be teenagers? Or is this going to be a university or higher education roleplay where the characters are all over 18? This has a huge impact on the plots that the people that join your roleplay are going to be able and comfortable doing. Despite the fact that, of course, in reality, teenagers are not celibate, most roleplayers are not going to be interested doing not safe for work scenes with teenage characters. The reasons for this should be obvious, but if they're not, let me know down below, because that's a whole other video, a whole other topic that is beyond the scope of what we're talking about here today with setting up school roleplays. If you want your players and your characters to be able to engage with not safe for work content, I would recommend going for a college or university roleplay. Of course, if you want your roleplay to be safe for work in that sense, then it's totally fine to do a high school roleplay with teenage characters. The other thing to think about in regard to what characters will be featured in your roleplay is teachers. Do you want players to be allowed to create teacher characters? When it comes to school roleplays, allowing teachers as playable characters can quickly turn into you running essentially two roleplays. Because what types of events and plot drops and things like that are going to be inspiring for student characters is going to be different for teacher characters. There's a few different ways to go about solving this. The first way is the simplest, and it's just to make all teachers non-player characters. And that way, if they're non-player characters, anyone can control those teacher characters to do whatever they need the teacher to do. If you still do want people to be able to play teacher characters, however, and you don't want them to be non-player characters, another way to solve this is to allow people to play teacher characters as their secondary character. So first they'll have to make a student character when they join the roleplay, but then when they roll up a second character, that character can potentially be a teacher if they want to. You'll also need to consider, are teacher-student ships allowed in your roleplay? If you allow teacher characters, roleplayers are going to expect to be able to do student-teacher ships. So if you allow teacher characters and don't allow that type of ship, I would really consider not having teacher characters and just let them be non-player characters. That type of ship is very popular, and if you do this, it's going to disappoint a lot of people that join your game. So just spend some time thinking about how you want teachers to function within your game and make sure the setup for how they work matches those goals with how the teacher characters should work. Of course, there is no one right or wrong answer for how to do teacher characters. Personally, I let them be NPCs. I think that's the easiest thing and it's the most satisfying thing as far as myself and my players are concerned, and then everybody's comfortable in that situation. But it's something you need to think about before you get too far in designing your school roleplay, because depending on how you do with teacher characters and whether this is a high school versus a college or a university is really going to change what types of players your roleplay attracts.
So editing Karen here for a moment, because I don't think I made this super clear in the video. If you are running a roleplay where the characters are high school aged and you allow teachers as player characters, people are going to want to do student teacherships with underage characters. That's just something you'll have to deal with. And what that means is that you will attract pedos. So that's what I'm trying to say here. YouTube, please don't suppress this video. I'm trying to like help and protect the kids. I'm not trying to like, you know, do anything bad by using that word. So thanks. And be careful, guys, out there running high school role plays. Okay, back to not editing Karen, regular video Karen. Thanks.
Okay, so you've decided on your age range. You've decided how you're going to handle teachers. What next? Now we need to pick the particular type of school for your role play. This is all about location, location, location. The location of your school determines so much about how that school works. A high school in the US is totally different than a high school in the UK or Japan or Brazil or wherever in the world your role play is set. Even if your role play is a fantasy school, I still recommend finding a similarly structured school in the real world and modeling your school after that. Why? Because if you have your school modeled after a type of school in the real world, it's one less thing your players will need to learn when they're engaging with your role play. This is going to help bring players into the world of your school. This is going to take research. Take US colleges, for instance. A state-run university is different than an Ivy League school, is different than a tech school, is different than a community college. If you have not actually attended the type of school that is in your roleplay, you will need to research, research, research. Don't skip this step. Your players will notice and appreciate the research that you've done. Once you've researched the type of school that you're setting up, you'll need to work that research into the world of the school in your roleplay. This means you'll need a lore book of sorts that your players can look at to understand exactly how the school is set up and how it's run and what to expect when they're playing their characters in that school. So, what sorts of things should be mentioned in a school roleplay's lore book? Where are your students living? Is this a boarding school or a university where there's going to be dorms? Is this maybe a neighborhood school where all the students live in basically the same neighborhood? Or maybe this is a school where students are busing from all over the area into that particular school because it's some sort of specialized school. What sorts of classes does your school offer? I recommend listing the available classes in your lore book and also having a method for players to add their own classes to the roleplay if they want to. What sorts of amenities does your school have? A cafeteria, a library, sports fields, a pool? I recommend taking a few sentences in your lore book and describing these sorts of shared places at your school so that when people are writing about them, they have a shared vision in their mind of what these places look and act like. If you decided to make your teachers NPCs, you'll also want a spot where you describe all of those NPC teachers. What else do you guys like to add into the lore books of your school role plays? Let me know down below. Okay, so we mentioned classes, but how do we actually handle classes in a school roleplay? Depending on the type of school that you've chosen for your roleplay, you'll need to make a decision on if players need to put their character's school schedule into their application. If players deciding at the application level their entire school schedule is too much for what you're trying to do, I recommend instead having a question that's like favorite class or something similar to that. The reason why we do this is because even if our players aren't really writing about the classes that they're attending too much, which most of the time you don't play out actually going to class because that's boring, why would you do that? You still want to make sure that the characters aren't forgetting they're going to class. This happens in a lot of TV shows that are at schools and things like that. You sort of forget about the school aspect, but if we forget about it, then why is this a school roleplay to begin with, right? So we want to make sure that we remember this is a school and your characters are going to class. So it's kind of been a while since I did one of these particular videos for setting up a certain type of roleplay. I did one for canon roleplays, which I'll link up in the card there. Yeah, there. And you guys can go check that one out, but I'm planning on doing some more of these in the future. So let me know down below what types of roleplays you would be interested in seeing kind of a layout of how to design it like this. So how do you guys set up your school roleplays? Let me know down below.
Thank you very much for watching to the end of the video. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and ring that bell if you want to help my channel grow. If you'd like to support me, link to my Patreon is in the description, as well as my Amazon page to buy my book. Right here is where the names of my $5 and up patrons will go starting in November. And don't forget to make it a great day.